Humans have evolved to the point where we've developed and cultivated complex systems of communication, often aided with the help of technology. Animals have also developed their own unique systems of communication, which sometimes can be remarkably sophisticated and other times can be notably bizarre. Some animals will whistle, grunt, growl, and even use electricity to get their messages across. Others may check the poo of their animal peers to find out more about them and their situation. These are a few of the strangest ways that animals communicate in the wild. See how we compare. You'll likely grow a new appreciation for how far we've come. Gorillas hum and stick out their tongue. If a gorilla sticks out his tongue at you, he isn't just giving you a rude simian equivalent of a raspberry. He's feeling threatened, and sticking out his tongue is an act of aggression that signals it's time to back off. But gorillas can be polite as well. They tend to hum happily when they're about to eat. It's a communal invitation to dinner for the rest of their group. Prairie dogs are talking about you when they see you. If you stumble upon prairie dogs and suddenly notice quite a bit of commotion, you might allow yourself to think they're talking about you. Don't worry, you're not crazy. They are talking about you. Research indicates that prairie dogs use a sophisticated language of squeals, whistles, and squeaks at varied pitches when approached by people or other animals. It seems each intruder's description differs. Bison move by consensus. Bison herd by democracy, as they will make decisions by voting. Really, the group will decide which way to travel with each member of the herd turning its body in the direction they'd like to go. When one member finally begins moving in a specific direction, the herd will follow, as long as the majority of the herd agrees. If they don't agree, the herd will continue to linger until a majority decision is eventually reached. Fireflies use Morse to mate. Dating in the human world can be so complicated, and in the insect world, fireflies don't have much time to fiddle around with such complications. When a male firefly is ready to mate, he will emit a glow to woo a potential female partner. When the female sees one she likes, a courtship will ensue and consist of a Morse code-like series of flashes back and forth. How simple and quaint! Octopuses change color. Surviving in the ocean for an octopus requires some special techniques and abilities. These soft-bodied, boneless mollusks can change the color and texture of their skin to camouflage themselves and hide from predators. They can also use their color-changing abilities to communicate during a confrontation with another octopus. Becoming a darker color signifies aggressive behavior, while a paler color can signify an octopus will retreat from the confrontation. Geckos order takeout. The gecko has developed quite an interesting way to communicate with small insects called treehoppers. The tiny insect will drill into trees to drink the sap, which they digest, and then excrete as a sweet substance referred to as honeydew. Apparently, geckos love to eat honeydew. They go so far as to order takeout from treehoppers, with the gecko strolling up and simply nodding when he's hungry. The treehopper will then shake around before sending a tiny sugary poo pellet into the gecko's mouth. Yum. Cats meow exclusively for humans. We're used to hearing cats meow, but little did we know that they save that vocalization just for us. The clever little felines reserve meowing almost exclusively for their human counterparts to ask for food, to go outside, or to get attention. For their other kitty and animal friends, cats typically use body language, growls, and hisses to communicate. When it comes to poo, cats bury theirs because of their self-protecting animal instincts. They don't want to draw attention from larger animals or predators. Demon mole rats are headbangers. The African demon mole rat lives in burrows underground where it's too dark to see and sound doesn't travel far enough for vocalizations to be useful. As solitary creatures, they prefer their personal space. When another mole rat gets too close, they will bang their heads rapidly, communicating by vibration to let their intruder know they're getting too close. Snakes communicate via taste. Snakes may not be the most extensive of communicators, but that doesn't mean they aren't without remarkable capabilities when it comes to communicating. Snakes use their tongues to taste the pheromones excreted by other creatures. As the snake sticks out its tongue, it picks up the pheromones in the air. They have receptors in their mouths that enable them to smell and taste the pheromones, identifying prey or potential mates. Some snakes also communicate using sound, such as the rattlesnake, which uses its rattle and hiss as a warning to predators, alerting them to stay away. Crickets compete in chirping duels. Many are familiar with the chirping sound made by crickets, which is a mating call made only by the males. They make this sound by rubbing their forewings together, with the teeth-like ridges from the bottom of one wing scraping against the other. Interestingly, male crickets sometimes compete in chirping duels, trying to outdo each other when it comes to finding mates. Now you know why they get so loud. Ravens use gestures to communicate. Ravens are very intelligent birds that use their beaks and wings to make gestures. They can point to objects much like people do with their hands. They do this to show and offer gifts to members of the opposite sex, who respond with attention and by looking at the objects. If interested, the two birds may then touch bills or handle the object together. They do this to attract partners or to strengthen a friendship with one of their peers. Electric rays use electricity to find mates. There are 69 species of electric rays that range in size from that of a dinner plate to about 3 feet across. The voltage they generate is relative to their size, with the larger ones able to produce a shock of up to 220 volts. Some use their voltage to stun prey, but not all of them do. Electric rays can also use their electric capabilities to communicate with each other and find mates. We're familiar with domesticated animals that are able to learn the meanings of human words such as sit, stay, heal, treat, and so on. But animals in the wild continue to amaze us with how they communicate with each other. Scientists, for the most part, still have to speculate about many of the ways these animals communicate, but now you may never see fireflies or hear crickets again without thinking, "That's some pickup line, buddy."